Hey guys, Wandering Shell here, and today we're going to be doing another Marvel United character. This time it's going to be Captain Marvel. Feels like I'm doing a women's thing. Maybe next time I'll do Black Widow, or somebody else. Anybody. Anyway, we're going to start doing yellow for her hair. This part was the easiest part because it's just plain yellow, and I'm so sorry, I'm still learning how to use this camera. Hence why most of this is off camera. Next, I started doing the biggest part, which is going to be the red. And this part was hard because her helmet is blended to her hair and to her face. So it was a little hard trying to figure out where does it end, where does it begin, especially her face. I definitely had to keep looking at the picture. Just to, as a reference, so I can figure out what am I doing wrong. Red part took so long to do because she had the shoulder pads, her helmet, she had her boots and her gauntlets, and each one will have not her helmet, but most of her gauntlets, her shoulder pads, and even her boots will have gold, and you'll see later on. But how annoying that was, because any part that had like a raised section, that was the gold. I try to slow it down, the video this time, making it a little bit slower, but not by much. It seems like the first one went a little too fast, so I try to slow it down in this one. I got better with the character being majority on the screen. As I say that, and all of a sudden she's now off camera. This part took me a long time to get done because of all the red locations. I did refer to the pictures, the images on my phone, on the instruction guide of where all the colors need to be. upside down. Which is a good thing. These types of contraptions that I'm using to hold the model in place is really good. You don't need to tack it on. It has like a little clamp on it. And it doesn't bend the figure either. Because that's what I was afraid of. That it's going to bend the base. And so it would be wobbly. Luckily, it didn't. So definitely spend a little extra money to get one of these. And it will help you in the long run. Because you never want to hold a figure with your bare hands. Because the oils in your skin can actually ruin the paint. And smudge it, and you don't want to smudge your nice model after you're working on it for who knows how long. And this is where the part where I even told you about the raise. Every raise location is gonna be the gold. Well, it sure was. And while I was painting it, the red and the gold were really nice looking. I was like, whoa, these blend so nicely. And yet, pop. It's like kind of like how Wasp in the previous episode, where the gold and the black just work so well together. Marvel knows what they're talking about. See, I put the bell piece gold also, because honestly, I have no idea anymore of where these colors are coming from, honestly, because all the images that I found of Captain Marvel is always a frontal, it's never behind, so I kind of just assume since the front piece is gold, let me do the back piece as gold. And this is the part where I'm doing her feet, and her feet were annoying because the cloth that's hanging is covering one of the feet. And it was hard to get to it without ruining everything else. Alright, it looks like I'm up to the part of the blue. So I used dark blue for this, deep blue for this section. Because if you start with a deep blue for this, and then when you get to the highlighting, you can use lighter blues to make the character pop more. So I chose deep blue first, and boy, I'm glad I picked deep blue because it looks beautiful. The gold, the red, and the blue all together, these are so nice looking. Like, you can tell right away, this is Captain Marvel. I hate doing like the models like butts and boobs, their butts mostly. It just feels so weird to do. Her legs are just very annoying because that cloth blocking her one leg made it very difficult trying to get to all the blue, and even her boots versus her pants, they blended in, so I couldn't tell where the boot begins or when the pants begin. So I kind of just guessed it at that point. And that's what a lot of times you have to do is, even when you're looking at pictures and stuff, you might have to just guess it. And it makes it your unique style. So don't go crazy about it. Don't be upset. This is your painting, your piece. This is your model that you're going to be using, and you're going to be proud of it. Where I'm starting to do a little bit more touch-ups. It seems like I put some blue in places that shouldn't be there, so I did a quick little touch-ups. What's nice about Army Painter paint, you can go over another color, and they're not gonna blend that easily, especially if they're dry. All right, This is the part where I'm doing her face, the whole little section, small little section of her face. I use Centaur skin color. It's a little bit, it's very pale. Because I know when I'm going to do the flesh wash, is she's going to be a darker color. And this is the part where I'm doing her eyes. This was the most annoying section ever. Because she has two little dots for eyes. There's no pupils, there's no nothing, it's just two little dots of eyes. And again, touching up again with the red near her face. Because she has like this red chin thing on her helmet. Alright, now the easy part is going to be the tones. I'm using a strong tone for her body and a flesh tone for her face. I did soft tone for Wasp last time and I felt like it really didn't do much for her. So I try to do strong tone, which is a darker color, mostly it's like a darker brown color, to Captain Marvel. And I'm glad I did, because the parts where they're like indented and stuff, especially where the red is, it makes it look really nice looking. Flesh wash part. You can never go wrong with this part of the tones of the wash. Now keep in mind, the darker you put, the amount of you put in will be the darkest part. And now we're up to my favorite, is the highlights, and I do mostly dry brushing. For her hair, I try to keep it not really dry brushed, I try to keep it more yellow, because I want that to pop more. So I kind of just paint it over the raised pieces. Then her helmet, I try to keep it as red as I can, but still have some of that tone in there to give it some dimension. Because it's not actually that, it's not really a helmet, it's kind of like a leather almost. So we'll have like an indents and stuff from her hair, or, you know, maybe some like damage or something. Damage from battle, I should say. A lot of her images in the manual guide shows like a blue tint to her on the right side. I didn't want to do that, because when you're actually playing the game, it's just a weird light just kind of shining through in a random spot. So instead, I not even do that. I just kind of left it as a quick little dry brush. I didn't really give her section where the light is shining on it, because the lights from, you know, from like your living room or from your dining room or your kitchen is gonna give her that light, especially when you're playing the game. Looks like we're almost up to the last bit. I didn't record doing the base this time, because it was just a quick little, thing of putting black on and then dry brushing a gray, because it's supposed to be pavement. So I'm trying to fix a little bit of her face, because I felt like the flesh wash made her face a little too dark. Fixing that a bit. You can kind of see in the corner there of all the gold still everywhere in the palette. actually the best part, is doing the dry brushing for the blue part. Because again, as I said, I mentioned earlier, if you do a dark tone, the deep blue first, and then you can use lighter blues for the highlights, and it makes it pop. When you'll see the thumbnail of the character, you'll see the blues really pop in the dark, in the deep blue. Alright, we're almost done. Like, comment, and subscribe if you guys want to see more of Marvel United figures be painted. And I guess I'll see